Keep going, everybody. Get hyped up. Get clap. I'm here now. Good stuff. Okay. Guys, I feel like there's just a lot of energy in the room. You know what I mean? Throwing me back a lot of positive stuff. And I just want to tone things down a little bit. You know, really connect with you and let you know a little bit about myself. I have clinical depression. Or as my cousin would call it, a case of the bitch niggas. my cousin is a fucking moron. He's not a smart man. He once told me the reason why I'm so sad is because I wasn't getting enough Ja Rule in my life. That's a quote. That's a quote. Oh, God. The black community is ridiculous because when we have problems like depression or any other mental disorder, we don't get professional help. We just treat our barbers like our therapist. Like, I'll go into a barbershop, not even need a haircut, and just complain all day. Like, I'll just be there and just be like, oh, fucking, you know, Jamal, you know, it's been a really tough day. It's been a tough couple weeks, man. I don't know if I can, like, do this anymore. I don't know if I can keep going. And it's like, what? This greenlit scandal for another season, son. Stay up. It's fucking ridiculous. Friday's on TNT tonight. It gets better. It gets better. It's fucking awful. Fucking terrible. Oh, God, man. We're just ridiculous fucking people. I don't even know. Let's see. I'm going to tell you guys a little bit about myself also a little bit more. I'm from New Jersey, right? Are there any New Jersey people in the house right now? No? Not at all? Fuck you guys. A lot of my friends, you know, are from the city or from random places and stuff, and they always ask me what New Jersey is like, and I'll tell you what I tell them. If you're a fan of a bunch of drunk Italians calling you one of the good ones, then New Jersey might be for you. It's a great place. It's so fun. Oh, it's great. I was back in New Jersey the other day, and I bumped into my third grade teacher, right? We caught up, I told her a little bit about my life and everything I was going through. She was like, oh my God, I'm so happy for you. I'm so impressed. It's like, impressed? Bitch, I used to have dreams. When I was in the third grade, I dreamed that I would be a lawyer or a doctor. I never dreamed that I would be a busboy who watches Battlestar Galactica and cries during Google commercials. You know? It's fucked up. It's fucked up. But I feel like that's all a part of growing up, right? You know? You gotta, like, you realize what life has in store for you and just choose obtainable dreams. That's what my new dream is, to become a magical Negro in a straight-to-DVD movie. It's gonna be great. Look out for it. It's coming out this summer. It's called Introducing Phil Burke and Uses Smarts. I just want to teach a young white boy that he can do anything he wants to do, even though the world teaches him that already. What is the function of the magical Negro? Like, I feel like they need to have a TED Talk about that. You know? Fuck yeah, just all that shit, fuck the environment. They used to talk about that, like, it's just me up there with a headset and a laser pointer. Just like, what is Beggar Vance? Like, that's what needs to happen. Again, guys, you guys are just too rowdy in here, you know? You're too happy to see me. You're getting a little bit wild, and I just want to get serious and take things down a notch, okay? You look like you're loving it right now. No. Just fucking relax. I just want to do a quick PSA about lotion and its hold on the black community. Okay? You three look like you moisturize. You look like you can relate. Okay? I will say this. No matter how free black people are, we will always be a slave to lotion. It's fucking ridiculous. I talk to all my like white comic friends, and they're like, oh man, if I ever like get rich, man, I'd be like a mansion, I'd be like a bunch of fancy cars. If I was rich, all I would do is buy a fucking swimming pool, fill it with Jergens, and just swim in it all day. All day. Relentlessly. That's all I need, man. I don't even need to be rich. I just need to make like 50 grand. And just roll around in a kiddie pool full of fucking Dove body soft. Like, that's all I need. It's awful. Like, and every time I do this joke, there's always like a white comic that'll tell me, you know, like, Phil, we use lotion too. It's like, you do, but you don't. You know? Like, lotion to you is like your side bitch, you know? Like, you see it at the bar, she's looking hot, she's looking nice, you're like, I'll try her out, you know? Me and lotion grew up together, okay? Like, when me and lotion lost our virginity to Pornhub.com, we both cried. You know, it's serious, it's serious. The other day, I ran out of lotion, and I started crying like a black mother in a hood movie. I was like, no. Jerry's got a scholarship, he was supposed to go to college, no. Fucking terrible, oh God. I feel like the way white people feel about, like lotion is the way black people feel about guacamole. You know? Like, it's there, try a scoop. But I'm never gonna call it guac. You know? I'm never gonna get to that point. If I love lotion enough, I'll call it lotion. I don't give a fuck. I'll just slather it on and just tell it how much I love it. Oh man. Respect it. Respect it, white people, okay? Oh man, what else? It was nice being back in New Jersey. I did a show out there actually the other day too. And you should have seen like a couple of my friends came out to see me, like, you know, do my show and everything. And I did well. As usual, okay. You should have seen how angry they were that I did well. Like, I don't know what it is about guys and guy friends, but there's nothing better than seeing your good guy friend fail miserably at something that they love. Oh, I just fucking, this is like the sweetest fucking victory ever. You want to savor every goddamn moment of it, you know? Like, I feel like women are like, they're so much kinder to the friends, you know? Like, if a woman sees her friend crying, she'll be like, oh my God, what's wrong? She has to get to the root of the problem, right? If a guy sees this her crying, all he's trying to do is take a fucking picture. He doesn't care. He's calling up all his other friends. He's like, yo, Thomas Francis had a miscarriage. He's crying like a little bitch. It's awful. He's like, bro, I already got it on my Facebook. Throw it on Instagram. It's going to be awesome. Put some filters on it. It's going to be great. Fucking, oh, we're so fucking shitty to each other all the time. But I feel like as men, like, that's the sign of, like, true friendship, you know? Like, I feel like women are shitty to each other, but, like, just in a different way, right? Like, you ever hang out with a girl before, and you meet all of her friends, and then you hang out with her again, and one of them's missing? They never tell you what happens. Start getting all cryptic, talking like a fucking mob boss. You're like, what happened to Sarah? Sarah fucked up is what happened to Sarah. Sarah is no longer here is what happened to Sarah. Sarah's at Tandem Bar watching Phil Burke do okay. That's what happened to Sarah. You don't want to be where Sarah's at right now. Oh, fuck. How much time do we have, Ronnie? No?
You want to get a drink?
You want to get a drink? Okay.
30 seconds.
40 seconds. Oh, man.
Just fine for
a day. Okay. That's cool. I back in New Jersey was fun because I get to see my grandmother. I'm very close to her. She's a great woman. She has a lot of wise words. Like the last time I talked to her, she told me that she only listens to country music because she likes to hear white people cry. It was fucking amazing. That is the wisest thing I've ever heard in my life. Fucking beautiful. She is a great, great...